It's the end. The end of beginning. And the beginning of...
End? No. That can't be it. The beginning of next? The beginning of middle? Okay, so none of those were good, so we're gonna roll with the beginning of forever. Not only does it sound way cooler, but it makes a lot more sense, especially if you saw my last video. Okay, cool. We good with that? Now back to the story. Ah, yes. Thanks, me. The end of beginning, and the beginning of forever. Dear future me, there's a concept I've understood for a while but failed to carry out, and it's that to accept my new life, I have to kill off my old one. My habits, my lifestyle, my character. Even a simple memory can hold me back. And I'm writing this because I want to apologize in case I've disappointed you. I know what I want. I know the life I want to live. But sometimes, I get caught up trying to recreate memories or indulging into old habits that you no longer do. But not anymore. I want to be like you. A courageous, confident leader. Charismatic, disciplined, filled with purpose and drive. Healthy, strong, and most importantly, living the dream, man. Doing what you've always said you'd do since you were a kid. Running around the world, doing crazy shit, having more fun than anyone else, and making money off these silly little videos. By the age of 26, you've already formed enough memories to tell stories for two lifetimes. All because you followed your heart and trusted your gut when it mattered most. I admire that. So, I think it's time to get rid of the old me. Not forever, just put him up on the shelf for a little bit. For now, I think it's time I start acting a little bit more like you. See you soon. Love, Nick. I apologize. It's mostly eaten already. Don't look at my toes. Don't look at my toes. Don't look at my toes. Look how dialed I am. Mango, grapefruit, force of nature, jalapeno cheddar sausages, organic blueberries, and this is a mix of organic mango peach, lightly sweetened iced tea, orange juice, and sparkling water. That is fire. That is so fire. Eating like this makes me so happy. And I just feel so like, yeah, yeah. It's like, yeah, just like, I'm dialing and I'm tweaking the knobs, and it's been such a great day. I woke up this morning, I went for a walk with my dog, I went straight to iFly. Now I'm eating this meal, then I'm probably gonna go play disc golf, maybe slackline a bit, swim, hang out with the boys. What a day. Doesn't get better than this. What a way to start the summer. What a way to start the fucking summer, and it's only gonna go up from here. I have a feeling it's gonna be a good one. I just have this feeling. Something in the air. There's something in the air. I have a plan as well. I have a plan. Hello there. Editor Nick here. Just popping in to tell you to remember this part. That's all I'm gonna say. Back to the vid. But first, let's have a beautiful, beautiful day. Hell yeah. This shit is so good, by the way. Oh, yeah, fuck me. Oh, I love you, miss. The money's bread. And you will be grieved and strong, but I won't be blamed. Oh my god, it smells so good. There it is. It's so good.
She don't wanna be seen. Hey, yeah. We are back. so bad on the phone. And you will be grieved out
soon. But I won't be blind. Ladies and gentlemen.
Yo, let's do like a, we're back on three. One, two, three.
We're back. I fuck the no parking signs.
Yeah.
Fuck the no parking signs. Fuck the no parking. Fuck them.
Yeah. We're one step ahead.
Yeah.
It's actually beautiful.
Look at that.
All right, so remember that plan I was talking about? Well, here it is. This piece of paper, this glorious, glorious piece of paper. So real quick, let me explain the purpose of this paper. It all started with this one post-it note. Meet people, do more exciting things outside the house, and film it all. I wrote this post-it note when I was finally able to pinpoint why I was so unsatisfied with my life at the time. So with a few additions, I turned it into a checklist that I could use every single week to make sure I'm doing all the right things. And here it is. The gist of it is less screen time, more time outdoors doing things with people, and prioritizing my health. That's it. This way, if I'm checking at least 80% of the boxes, I know I'm on track with doing the things I actually care about and staying away from the things that aren't helping me reach my goals. This piece of paper right here is essentially my plan to make this summer and the rest of the year the best year and summer yet. The summer had kicked off to an amazing start, and it wasn't even June yet. My friends were coming home from school, the weather was getting warm, and the trees were turning green again, and there was not a single boring day in my calendar. Hiking, fishing, the first cliff jump of the season, I even completed my first solo skydive. But the real icing on the cake was a trip I had been planning for a while. 1 week at a surf camp in beautiful Costa Rica. The same kind of music. I don't want to talk about Costa Rica too much because I have so many amazing memories I could go on forever. From learning how to surf to riding on the back of the sketchiest car I've ever seen, ripping ATVs through the jungle, taking my first real cold plunge at a random villa mansion party, playing pool volleyball in the pouring rain, and meeting some of the most amazing people I have ever met, you could say it was a decent trip. But no matter how much I tried to hold on to every moment I could, eventually, like all good things, this too had to end.
Okay, real talk here, people. I get it. I get it why people travel now for months at a time and don't come home, because it's fucking hard going on a trip. Okay, I know, cry me a river, whatever, blah, 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 right? But it's hard going on a one-week trip, meeting so many amazing people, having, like, the best time you've ever had in your entire life, and then coming back home, and knowing you might not see those people again for years, you might not see those people again ever, and, like, you forget about the shit that goes on at home, even the simple things, like doing dishes. I haven't done dishes in, like, 2 weeks, now I'm sitting here doing dishes, like, what? And it's, you get, like, so detached from reality, it's insane. I know, I sound like a little bitch, but on one end, I can't complain. My home life is amazing. I'm super grateful I get to stay at home and save money. And on the other end, I'm just, I'm tired of it. I'm ready for a change, ready for something new. Let's try for no reason. Let's see what these wheels let. Let's grind
Do you ever feel like you've outgrown a place? Like the place you used to call home no longer feels like home? Like the people you once knew no longer feel like the people you know now? And like the places you used to drive to with your friends on those magical summer nights lost their magic? Because I do. Sometimes it feels like the universe is telling
me. Wait, rewind, right there, okay, pause. I know this is really bad timing, and I'm interrupting this very emotional, heartfelt scene. But can we take a look at this ice cream sandwich? Just for one second. That's a brownie on the bottom, cookies and cream ice cream, Nutella topped with a warmed white chocolate macadamia nut cookie. That was hands down the best ice cream sandwich I have ever eaten. Ever. Okay, so where were we? Oh yeah, outgrown a place, places lost their magic, yada yada yada. Back to the story.
Sometimes it feels like the universe is telling me to run away and never come back. All of my favorite spots are either getting demolished or shut down. My friends are graduating college and getting big boy jobs. Even Pat Sajak retired from Wheel of Fortune, the only show I would watch every night with my parents. I'm 21 years old now, and it feels like adult life is really starting to catch up to me. Every day feels more packed with responsibilities than the last, leaving less room for the fun stuff. It feels like the inner child within me is slowly fading into the darkness and will continue to fade until all that's heard is a distant echo. Sometimes I sit here and I feel like there is no hope. But sometimes, a tiny flame ignites deep within my soul, just warm enough for me to notice it. A glimmer of hope that maybe I'm just getting started. Maybe nothing changed, and nothing has to change, and nothing will change. Maybe nothing lost its magic. Maybe the person I'm becoming will allow me to see the same world I've seen every day through new eyes. Maybe the people I once knew are becoming my new favorite people I'm soon to know. Maybe everything I'm doing isn't pointless. Maybe I'm not failing myself and my parents and the people around me. Maybe I'm actually succeeding. Maybe things are working out exactly as they're supposed to. And maybe, just maybe, this isn't the end. Maybe it's just the beginning. That tiny flame proves to me that this is it. I'm living it. I see it. I feel it in my bones. This is where my new life begins.
Chicken, salad,
mayo, onions.
That's so funny. I haven't twisted a beard forever.
Wow.
I have to say about that. Nature is healing.
Oh,
you have to say about that.
I didn't know that turkeys flew.
Don't you imagine that?
Look at him!
Why are you doing this for free, Nick? You shouldn't do this for free. Ask for money next time. Is it real or is it cake? You know that show? It's like, is it real or is it cake? And you're like, oh, it's good. Imagine somebody just see a big dice come down from the sky. It's like, this all cake and it's just trembling around. It's like,
I promise I'm not on drugs. I like actually swear to God.
Can we see thumbs up, Rock? Thumbs up, Rock.
Super deep narrator voice incoming. The rain falls. Oh my God.
Are you blinking like Morse code or something?
Drake Police Collab.
Oh, finally. Holy shit. So nice to be back.
It is crazy. I do this on the daily. I treat it really nicely. I forget the lyrics.